हेलो ऑल। सो इन दिस लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न द प्रेशर मेजरमेंट पार्ट टू। ऑल्सो वी हैव सीन इन लास्ट लेक्चर द थियरी रिलेटेड टू द प्रेशर मेजरमेंट सिस्टम्स, हाउ द प्रेजेंट प्रैक्टिसेस आर देयर इन प्रेशर मेजरमेंट सिस्टम्स। वी आर लर्निंग ए लेक्चर सेशन ऑन फ्लूइड मैकेनिक्स एंड फ्लूइड एंड टर्बो मशीनरी। सो बेसिक्स ऑफ फ्लूइड्स, देन प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ फ्लूइड्स एंड प्रॉब्लम्स ऑन द वेरियस प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ फ्लूइड्स वी हैव कंप्लीटेड, एंड नाउ वी हैव स्टार्टेड द नेक्स्ट पार्ट ऑफ द फ्लूइड मैकेनिक्स लेक्चर सेशन इज प्रेशर मेजरमेंट। सो इन दिस प्रेशर मेजरमेंट वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न वॉट आर द वेरियस डिवाइसेस विच आर यूज फॉर मेजरिंग द प्रेशर, एंड ऑल्सो हाउ और इन विच वे द पर्टिकुलर अमाउंट ऑफ प्रेशर इज टू बी मेजर्ड। माई नेम इज सावन वानी, आई एम असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग, पद्मभूषण वसंतराव दादा पाटिल इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी, भूतगांव, एंड वी आर गोइंग टू सी द प्रेशर मेजरमेंट इन दिस सीरीज। बिफोर दैट आई वुड लाइक टू आस्क यू ऑल फॉर सब्सक्राइब माई चैनल एंड व्यू द वेरियस वीडियोज रिलेटेड टू द इंजीनियरिंग प्रैक्टिसेस। सो गोइंग टू द फर्स्ट स्लाइड नाउ इन दिस लेक्चर, मेजरमेंट ऑफ प्रेशर, हाउ द पर्टिकुलर प्रेशर मेजरमेंट इज डन। सो बेसिकली द प्रेशर ऑफ द फ्लूइड मे बी मेजर्ड विद द फॉलोइंग डिवाइसेस। सो फर्स्ट यू कैन से दैट द मैनोमीटर्स आर द डिवाइसेस विच कैन मेजर द प्रेशर, एंड ऑल्सो देर आर मैकेनिकल गेजेस विच आर यूज फॉर मेजरिंग द प्रेशर्स। सो नाउ हाउ द मैनोमीटर्स आर डिफाइंड। मैनोमीटर्स आर डिफाइंड एज द डिवाइसेस विच आर यूज फॉर मेजरिंग द प्रेशर एट अ पॉइंट इन अ फ्लूइड बाय बैलेंसिंग द कॉलम ऑफ फ्लूइड बाय द सेम और अनदर कॉलम ऑफ लिक्विड। These are classified as follows. Now see, these manometers are nothing but the balancing of the column of the fluid. There is one tube in which the manometer can be used, can use an another liquid or the same liquid whose pressure is to be measured at that point. And therefore, by balancing the column of the liquid in the same particular column of the liquid, we can measure the pressure at that point. So that pressure which we'll be measuring will be in terms of pressure head. So we can have various types of manometers. So first thing, the manometers are classified by simple manometers and differential manometers. In simple manometers, we are having piezometer, then U-tube manometer, and single column manometer. And the B type is differential manometer. So what we are going to do in this lecture, we will limit our system to a particular only simple manometers. In next lecture, we are going to determine the differential manometers. So therefore, first thing we are going to start with the mechanical gauges first, the another type of the pressure measuring systems. After manometers, some mechanical gauges are used for measurement of pressure. So what are these gauges? These are the devices in which the pressure is measured by balancing the fluid column by spring or dead weight. So here we can get directly the output in terms of a point of the pointer pointing on the scale of the reading, and therefore we can get the value of the pressure. And here the fluid column is balanced by with the help of the spring or the dead weights. Generally, these gauges are used for measuring high pressure and where high precision is not required. So some commonly used are some one is boron tube pressure gauge, which is mostly used in all the industry applications or laboratory equipments. Then diaphragm pressure gauge. Third is bellow pressure gauge. And fourth is the dead weight pressure gauge. Now this dead weight pressure gauge is used for calibrating all the types of the pressure gauges which are used. So now we'll start with our manometers, that is simple manometers. So a simple manometer is one which consists of a glass tube whose one end is connected to a point where pressure is to be measured and the other end remains open to atmosphere. Now see, there is one concept of a manometer that where pressure is to be measured, at that point we have to connect the one point of manometer and other is to be kept open to the atmosphere. This is nothing but the working of a simple manometer. So whether it will be employing an liquid whose pressure is to be measured or another liquid, so that the balancing of the liquid column will be done with the help of two liquids and we can get the रीडिंग. सो दिस इज नथिंग बट ए सिंपल मैनोमीटर हुज वन एंड इज कनेक्टेड एंड अदर एंड इज ओपन टू एटमोस्फियर. सो द प्रेशर डिफरेंस विल बी क्रिएटेड विल बी बिटवीन द पॉइंट एट विच प्रेशर इज टू बी मेजर्ड एंड द एटमोस्फेरिक प्रेशर. Then the first type of simple manometer is a piezometric tube. So just guys observe this diagram. Now here there is an open vessel and the piezometric tube is connected at the bottom side of that and it is open to atmosphere at the upper end. So this is a piezometric tube. So always remember this piezometric tube will only use the liquid whose pressure is to be measured. So no any another liquid can be used in piezometric. So this piezometer tube employs only the liquid whose pressure is to be measured. So it is just a simple tube. So you can see here that as the vessel height is increasing, naturally there is an increase in height in the piezometric tube. So this height will give us the value of the pressure when we multiply this height by using the specific weight. So this pressure at point A we can calculate here. If you take this point A, then pressure will be equal to W into H. A piezometric or a piezometer in the simplest form of manometer, which can be used for measuring moderate pressures of liquid. So it is used for measuring moderate pressures. It consists of a glass tube shown in the figure inserted in the wall of a vessel or a pipe containing liquid whose pressure is to be measured. So here you can see it is connected to the vessel, but otherwise sometimes it can be connected to the actual wall of the vessel also, so that for measuring the actual pressure of the liquid. But now some distance is kept and then it is been extruded up to the certain height. The tube extends vertically upwards to such a height that liquid can freely rise in it without overflowing. The pressure at any point in the liquid is indicated by the height of the liquid in the tube above that point, which can be read on the scale attached to it. Thus, if W is specific weight of the liquid, then the pressure at point A is known as P is equal to W into H. This is a simple equation how to calculate the value of pressure at that particular point. So only one thing we have to consider, that the piezometer tube should be attached to the vessel in such a way that the piezometric tube, the fluid in that should not be overflowed. So that is the meaning of the particular value of, or measuring the value of the pressure with the help of piezometric tube. Then here you can see this is the piezometric tube, that is point A, and then the height will be taken. So that was the through a vessel. Here you can use for a pipe also. So you can see here that this is the pipe section and to that a piezometric tube is employed. So piezometers measure gauge pressure only at the surface of the liquid. That is, since the surface of the liquid in the tube is subjected to atmospheric pressure, a piezometer tube is not suitable for measuring negative pressure, as in such case the air will enter the pipe through the tube. So that is the thing, that as it employs only one liquid whose pressure is to be measured, that is giving us the value of pressure. So naturally it is only used for measuring the gauge pressure instead of measuring the both pressures, that is vacuum and gauge. Only we can measure gauge pressure with the help of piezometric tube. So here in this diagram you can see it is employed to a pipe, and to this pipe section actually we can measure the pressure at each and every point. So you can employ the various types of piezometers on the various types of pipe sections in order to find the intensity of pressure at that particular point. So this height will give us the value of the pressure head. Then second is a U-tube manometer. So now here just a diagram is shown of a U-tube manometer employing two liquids. One liquid will be there in this white section and this again second section. So these actually these two pipes are nothing but the limbs of a manometer, and this is a U-tube manometer as it is having a shape of a U. Center we will have the scale, or in sometimes the scale is attached to this limb also and the second limb also, but for measurement purpose, easy measurement purpose, the scale is employed at the middle section. And in this, the difference in the levels of two limbs can be regarded as the head of the, or the pressure head value of the manometers. So piezometers cannot be employed where large pressures in lighter liquids are to be measured, since this would require very long tubes which cannot be handled conveniently. So this is nothing but a disadvantage of a piezometer, that if large pressures is to be measured from that particular liquid, then the water will overflow. So to prevent that overflow of the water, then at that point we have to increase the height of the piezometric tube, which is not able to handle. Furthermore, gas pressures cannot be measured by piezometers because a gas forms no free atmospheric surface. So here there is again limitation for piezometer that we cannot measure gas pressures because it is open to atmosphere. These limitations can be overcome by the use of U-tube manometers. A U-tube manometer consists of a glass tube bent in U-shape, one end of which is connected to the point at which pressure is to be measured and other end remains open to the atmosphere as shown in figure. So you can see that if we have to measure the point at pressure point of the pressure at point 1 here, that is P1, then this P2 is open to atmosphere, or vice versa, where the pressure is to be measured, it is connected to the pipe and other end is open to atmosphere. So what this will do is this will just exert a pressure difference between the point at which pressure is to be measured and the atmospheric pressure, and therefore due to this the there will be a difference in the levels of either the manometric fluids like mercury or alcohol, whichever the manometric fluid will be used. Then we can, with the help of the pressure difference created, that is limb difference, we can easily find the pressure in that particular or that particular point. Now for positive pressure, now we can see that the measurement of the particular pressure can be done in two stages, for finding out gauge pressure, that is positive pressure, or we can find out the negative pressure, that is the vacuum pressure. So this diagram will show us that point A is there where it is to be connected and the pressure is to be measured at point A. So it has been connected to this U-tube manometer whose this end, that is upper end, is open to the atmosphere, and therefore the height now, this XX is nothing but the reference level, and this XX is also called as the datum line. So from this we are going to measure both heights. So you can see this pink color which is shown, that may be a manometric liquid, which we have seen that it is a mercury or a alcohol. So the height from this datum head to the upper head of the upper level of the manometric fluid, and from this datum line to this particular point, how the value of pressure head can be measured, now we are going to see. So let A be the point at which pressure is to be measured and XX is the datum line. Let H1 is height of the liquid, light liquid in the left limb above the datum line. So this is the lighter liquid. Always remember that manometric fluids which are there, manometric liquid is always the heavier liquid as compared to the manometric liquid, or as compared to the lighter liquid whose pressure is to be measured. Then H2 is the height of the heavy liquid in the right limb above the datum line. Small h is the pressure in pipe expressed in terms of head. So we have to find the value of h. So now see, as there are two fluids, so there will be the two values of specific gravity. So S1 is specific gravity of light liquid and S2 is the specific gravity of the heavy liquid. So the pressures in the left limb and right limb above the datum line are equal, because as the pressure at two points in at the same level is a continuous homogeneous liquid are equal, so therefore we can write it as both sides are equating the pressures, or we can see that both sides are keeping the system in equilibrium. So therefore pressure above XX in the left limb. So what will be happening to this pressure? Now here we have to find the pressure head. So it will have H as the limiting value of pressure or the unknown value of pressure, plus here lighter liquid is there, so height H1 into S1. So H plus H1 into S1. Again, I will repeat guys, here H is the unknown pressure which we have to measure at point A, plus H1 S1, that is the manometric, other than the manometric liquid, that is the fluid whose pressure is to be measured. So H plus H1 S1. H2 will be in the right limb, that is for the manometric fluid. So pressure head above XX in the right limb is only H2 S2, because there is no any water or any other fluid other than manometric fluid. So it is H2 S2. So now equating these two pressures, because we know that this system will be in equilibrium for measuring the pressure. So H plus H1 S1 is equal to H2 S2, or rearranging this equation, we will get H2 is equal to H2 S2 minus H1 S1. So in this way we can measure the pressure head when a simple manometer is there and it is connected to the point A whose pressure is to be measured. So here the comparison will be done between the atmospheric pressure and the point and the pressure at the point A. So therefore the difference will be created, and then the pressure head can be calculated with H is equal to H2 S2 minus H1 S1. then pressure head above for negative pressure. Now we have to measure the vacuum pressure. Now see, the level which was there in positive pressure was up to this much, but now it is below the datum line. So how to find this vacuum pressure here? First is the pressure at which the point at which the pressure is to be measured is again A. But now we have seen that due to the lower, that is vacuum pressure, the manometric liquid has started to just lower in this second limb and it is entering in the first limb. So now the H2 will become from datum line to the left side, and from above the H2 we will get H1. So now how the equation is carried out here: pressure head above the XX in left limb will be now H plus H1 S1 plus H2 S2, because here in the left limb you are having two fluids and they are having the various types of heads and specific gravity, and H we have to find here. So H plus H1 S1 plus H2 S2. Now what will happen in pressure head above XX in right limb? It will be zero, because there is no any fluid in this second limb above the datum line. So it is equal to zero. Again, equating the two pressures, H plus H1 S1 plus H2 S2 is equal to zero, or H is equal to minus into bracket H1 S1 minus or plus H2 S2. So here it will be the equation for calculating negative pressure, or directly we can say that it is a vacuum pressure. Now the third point, which is the last point of our lecture, then we are going to see the differential manometers and mechanical gauges in the next lecture. So here single column manometer, so you will see here that there is one reservoir, and this reservoir is going to help us for finding out the pressure at this point. So it is connected to this particular point where the whose water pressure or the liquid pressure is to be measured, and one end is again open to atmosphere. So what will happen is there will be a manometric fluid which will be entering, which is the heaviest fluid which will be entering in the reservoir, and at the same time the the fluid whose pressure is to be measured will be there in the reservoir. So due to the change in the pressure at this point, the pressure will be exerted on the heavier liquid, and this heavier liquid will change its position in the second limb, and therefore with this the help of this single column we can measure the pressure. The U-tube manometer described above usually requires a reading of fluid levels at two or more points, since a change in pressure causes a rise of liquid in one limb of the manometer and a drop in the other. This difficulty is however overcome by using single column manometer. So see, while using the simple U-tube manometer, there was one limitation of the rising and lowering of the manometric fluid in one column as compared to the other column. So this is overcome by using single column manometers. So a single column manometer is modified form of U-tube manometer, where a shallow reservoir having a large cross-sectional area, see the cross-sectional area dimensions, about 100 times as compared to the area of the tube, is connected in one limb of the manometer. For any variation in pressure, the change in that liquid level in the reservoir will be so small that it may be neglected, and the pressure is indicated by the height of the liquid in the other limb. So this is the value of the pressure which we were speaking about. As such, only one reading in the narrow limb of the manometer need to be taken for all pressure measurement. Means what? The rise of the value of H2 or the lowering of the value of H1 we will be taking into consideration, and directly we can measure the pressure. So guys, in this lecture we have seen how the manometers are used for measuring the pressure. Also, while learning this, we have seen that how the piezometric tubes are used, because in when we are going to learn further the various applications of the Bernoulli's equation like venturimeter, etc., there the piezometric systems are also more important. Like in Bernoulli's theorem applications, we require the piezometric tube, and that piezometric tube will be used for measuring the pressure head of the variable area test section. So these manometers are also used, but general limitation of these manometers is that they cannot use or cannot measure high amount of pressures. So for measuring high amount of pressures, we require various other types of mechanical gauges. In next lecture, we are going to see another type of manometer which is mostly used in all the particular areas of the industries, like differential manometers, where both points are connected to the system or points where the pressure are to be measured. And here up till now we have seen that one point is connected to the system and other is open to atmosphere. So now in next lecture we will see the another type of manometer, and plus we will see the mechanical gauges, various types of mechanical gauges for pressure measurement. Hope you have enjoyed this lecture. You can just post your queries if you have any, your suggestions regarding our lecture or regarding our YouTube channel. It is a kind request to all to subscribe our YouTube channel for receiving more and more videos, because from the heavy response received from your side, it motivates us for posting more and more lectures.